of the 14th Behmani king, Mahmud Shah, a young man arrived at his court from the famous city of Hamadan in Persia. This young man was destined to change the face, fate, and fortune of Golconda.
Sultan Quli, not only your bravery, but your knowledge is also praiseworthy.
My lord, it is your magnanimity which sees worth in this humble servant.
We hope that your stay at Bidur is comfortable.
Ali Jah, it is indeed gracious of you to have given refuge to me and my uncle in our exile.
Then why do you not settle here for good?
Ali Jah, for me, your desire is a command I cannot disobey.
Subhanallah, we hereby bestow on you the title of Qawas Khan and make you a noble at our court.
The ascent to Sultan Quli was meteoric. In just 7 years, he became Qutbul Mulk, the governor of Telangana, and the Jagirdar of Golconda. And after the death of Mahmud Shah in 1518, Sultan Quli became independent.
Bade Malik, there is peace and quiet in Vijayanagar and Vijayawada. The administration of Golconda too is stronger than ever before.
And we shall have to keep it so. Therefore, we have decided to make Golconda our capital.
But it is not in the center of the kingdom, my lord.
Nevertheless, there is no other place more suited for the defense of our kingdom. The Mud Fort already exists here. We shall strengthen this fort with stone and mortar, and reside here as well.
So, this was the first time that a ruler decided to make Golconda his capital and live there.
Absolutely. Sultan Quli had brought with him from Hamadan images of the towering minarets, grand arches, and magnificent gateways of Iran. All this is still visible here. Do you know that the circumference of the outer wall is 7?